I'm Trevor Nelson, and this is my self-portrait. I think it would have been obvious if I did something glamorous for my self-portrait. And I thought that, no, you know, what shaped me, you know, getting my first job was very important to me. I was 15. My first job was running a sort of fruit and veg come shop. And my job was to open it up on a Saturday morning at around 8 o'clock. The motivation really was money, I suppose, having independence, my own money, not having to ask my parents for pocket money. And in fact, I wanted to pay my own way at school as well, my school dinners and my bus fare. My attitude was, your day started at the end of work. You know, you can separate. You can work as a means to enjoy your hobby. And that's what I did. I liked buying records. Music was my buzz when I was a teenager. And in order to do that, I weren't going to get the money from parents. I had to earn my own money. So I'd work. And I'd enjoy work because I knew what it could do for me. It could fuel my hobby. And you know, I went to work with a smile on my face, on my skateboard, with a smile on my face, thinking, yeah, I'll skateboard there because I enjoy skateboarding. That'll get me there. I'll work. I quite enjoy the work, but it's still work. At the end of it, I might go to the record shop and spend half of my wages on records because I think I deserve it. And it means that if you work hard, you deserve to treat yourself. You know, otherwise, why get the treat? If you don't work, why are you going to treat yourself? How are you going to treat yourself? This is very much like where I used to work. It's a bit more civilised in here. my job would be to empty. My boss would get all the produce from the market very early. I'd empty it all out into different areas. You know, spuds, cabbages, leeks, courgettes, the lot, tomatoes. We had stalls out front, so I had to open the shop, get the shutter up, get the blind over, lay all the stalls out, all this before 8 o'clock in the morning before we opened. And that was the hardest job because it was so cold in winter. And it really made me realise those guys who work on real market stalls earn their money. I didn't love the job, but I love what the job did for me, you know? Gave me a lot of confidence, actually. Gave me a lot of confidence in my ability to communicate with people, to get on different levels, to communicate with not just people my own age, which kind of sets you up for the real big bad world out there, because the big bad world out there is like that. If you're not prepared to, if you've never spoken to people of a different background or different ages when you're a teenager, and all of a sudden you get a job at 20, and you're thrown into the lion's den, you may not be able to communicate with them. You're too used to mixing with your friends at clubs and talking about football and music and girls that you can't have a conversation with an adult anymore. Communication's the key for me in life. Being able to communicate with people is the key to any success I've had. It's the first sort of shop or consumer place I worked in where you had to deal with customers. And I grew up in a sort of closeted way of that all my friends were little black kids, and all of a sudden I'm dealing with Jewish people, Asian people, and you learn very quickly. I learned very quickly, yeah. You know, how to deal with people from different cultures, yeah, and backgrounds. It must have been the same thing, yeah, obviously, much more for you. I get a feeling a lot of young people that I encounter look at people like me and want what I've got, or, you know, want to do what I do, but they want to take shortcuts. And then they're always quite amazed when I tell them what I used to do and what I've done. The sort of jobs that they turn their noses up a lot of the time. Good things come to people who put effort in, you know, that's my feeling. And a lot of my mates at the time were really lazy, didn't want to do part-time jobs, just sponged off their parents. A lot of kids are like that today, don't like working part-time. But I always respect people who do. I go to McDonald's and I don't look at the person behind the counter with any feelings of you're on the lowest wage. I think you could be my boss one day. That's how I look at it. You know, the whole part-time job thing to me, it shaped my being, you know, having that ambition to work at 15. I never asked my parents for another penny after the age of 15, ever. Yeah. Well, listen, Ted, I'm doing a self-portrait, yeah, so I've got my camera. Can you take a picture of me outside your stall? It'd be really nice. All right, mate. Thanks a lot, Ted. That's my self-portrait. What's yours?